Hello and welcome to my channel, which is basically dedicated to Fusion 360, but in French. I make an exception for this video to be able to show that add-in I created to actually convert a file directly into a sketch in Fusion 360, a file. An airfall file. So it's very easy, very simple. I'll go through the different steps. So that's one result that you can see, but let's start from scratch, from nothing. So after you have installed the add-in, it will be there in your add-ins, airfall sketch from file. And it should be starting in the same time that you start Fusion 360 as basically all other add-ins. So as any other Fusion 360 command, you can put it up in the toolbar up there if you want to. It installs itself at the bottom of the sketch panel, just under sketch dimensions. And like I said, you can put it up to have the icon appear or use it from here. Here I started the command, but there is no sketch. So it tells you that you need to have a sketch active. So let's start by creating a sketch. And on that sketch, I will draw a line. And the line can be any length, any angle. Let's just do it that way. Now, if I start the command again, and I have the panel here, it tells me to select a construction line. So I can go ahead, do whatever I want. It will not select this line because it's not a construction line. So let's cancel that, press X to make it a construction line, select the command again, and now it will allow me to select this line. As soon as it's selected, it says selected and it's the OK button become enabled. Before it was impossible to click OK. Now, depending on the file, if it's a DAT file that you're going to select, you can have the name of the file in the sketch also. Okay, that works only for DAT file. For CSV file, it does not work because they're not consistent with that naming. The DAT files have a naming convention. So now select OK. You are going to, I have already selected, so it goes back to the same directory, but otherwise you will have to select the directory where you have stored your DAT files, and they can be in different places, that's up to you. And let's select this one, the FX60126, which is a Workman class of profile. And that's it. I have my airfoil which use the construction line as the chord or reference if you prefer for the profile. The length of that line is exactly the length of the profile drawn, and because I selected to have the name of the profile, I have it on my sketch to remember what it is. That is really up to you. So as you see, there is just, you know, you have to select file, first select a construction line, select a file matching one of the formats described in the help, and that's it. So just to say a word, the format accepted are CSV files, airfall CSV files, which can be either comma delimited or semicolon delimited. With Excel in Europe, basically by default, automatically, it will create semicolon CSV files because currency is expressed with a comma, so you cannot delimit with a comma. I mean, for an airfoil, you have only dots generally to separate the decimals, so it works with either colon, semicolon, sorry, or comma delimited. So both CSV files works. If it's a tab separated, it will not work. But I mean, to my knowledge, it's very rare that an airfoil file use tab as separator. But with Excel, you can change that. I mean, if it's tab separated, you can export as either comma or semicolon separated file. And it accepts also the DAT files in two formats. The CELIG format, which basically starts from the trailing edge, describes the coordinate of the X-Trados, that is the upper part of the profile. First, it goes up to the leading edge and then come back, describing the intrados, that is the bottom part of the profile. For the Lednisser file, it starts from the trailing edge. It starts like the CELIG format, but then for the bottom, for the extrados, for the intrados, sorry, for the bottom part of the wing, it goes back to start from the trailing edge. Okay, so it's a little different, but both, I mean, this extension understand and work with both type of profile of coordinate files. Well, anyway, thank you very much. I hope you find that useful. If you do, well, say so on the App Store. And well, you can always subscribe to my channel. Even if you don't understand French, you may be able to follow the motions and discover maybe a few things. Thank you for your interest and have fun. Take care. Bye bye.